Okay, magandang araw sa inyo. Now, before we start discussing the details about Rizal, let's examine this picture first. We have here the word colonialism. Now, if we're going to examine the word colonialism first, during the time of Rizal, colonialism was very rampant. When I say rampant, ibig sabihin, majority of the countries that time are exploring other territories. The word colonialism was derived from the word colony. Ibig sabihin ng colony, similar with the colony of an ant, ang colony means territory. So, ang primary objective of majority of the superpower countries that time, ng panahon ni Rizal, is to explore other territories, similar to the colony of an ant. So, let's check colony of an ant natin. So, ganito yung colony of an ant. Nasa isang territory sila, and then they're trying to explore other territories. Their group, isang grupo sila na nakatira sa isang territory. That's the essence. That's the essence of colony. So, ang colonialism, panahon ni Rizal, similar with the word imperialism. Imperialism or the empire. Imperialism is derived from the word, English word empire. So, meaning to say, it's kingdom, kaharian. So, ang objective of the majority of the superpower countries that time, yung mga country, is to explore other territories. This one, expansion of territories. Now, anong may encounter nating problem if countries are trying to explore other territories? Now, if I discover, for instance, this territory, there's a big chance that other countries would like to be involved in my territory as well. So, yan yung pinaka-major problem that a country may experience sa colonialism. June 19, 1861. Please try to remember this date. It's the birthday of Jose Rizal. So, 1861. Balikan natin yan. Kung napanood yung movie na Back to the Future, parang it's about going back to the past. During this time, panahon ni Rizal, nung pinanganak siya, 1890s, na-discover, or the electricity was introduced in our country. So, meaning to say, 1861, may kuryente na ba? Obviously, wala pa. Wala pang telepono. Why? Because 1876, na-discover lang ang telephone. Mode of transportation, obviously, wala pang aeroplano, wala pang railroad, and wala pang road vehicles. The only mode of transportation, land transportation that time was yung karwahe, carriage. We're going to discuss that later on. With regard to sea vehicles, yung mga sasakyang pandagat, meron tayong tinatawag na steam boat or a ship run by steam. So yun lang yung mode of transportation that time. So let's try to imagine anong mundo ang meron si Rizal that time. So, nung panahon ni Rizal, 1861, that's almost 160 years, more than 160 years ago. Nung panahon ni Rizal, America, yung state of America, or the United States, it's in the middle of turmoil. Magulo yung bansang Amerika. Why? Because during that time, when Rizal was born, there was an ongoing civil war. Ano po ba yung civil war? Ibig sabihin ng civil war, it's a war existing within the country. So yung mismong mga citizens, that's why civil, it pertains to the city. Mismong mga citizen dun sa mga sa bawat syudad, nag-aaway-away, may gera. Now, bakit may gera nun? It's because they were fighting for the freedom of black people. Kasi pa uso, it's a trend during the time of Rizal to have a black slave. People can be sold, especially racial discrimination. Asan ba yung racial discrimination here? This one. Ito. Racial discrimination. So, racial discrimination was very rampant. Yung America mismo are fighting for the freedom of everyone, including the black people. Individuals, malas mo, pag pinanganak kang maitim, chances are you're going to be sold to the upper class individuals, so the upper class society, and you will be considered as an object, hindi ka tao. So kung nabibili ka, kahit ano pwedeng gawin sa'yo nung nakabili sa'yo. Also during that time, after the Civil War, America helped Japan na mag-reopen sa mundo after 214 years. Western cultures were able to penetrate the Eastern culture of Japan. So in this case, people were introduced, people were oriented. Ano ba ang kultura sa kanluran? This result to enculturation of Japan. So nagkaroon ng opening of trades. That's the result of reopening Japan to the world. Nagkaroon ng open trade sa ibang bansa. And other conquering countries, imperialism, colonialism, ang pinaka prominent person during that time was Napoleon III. Napoleon III and France was able to conquer Mexico. Ang mga superpowers that time in terms of colonialism, in terms of imperialism, were Italy, Austria, and France. And Germans were fighting against other countries, specifically the France. The world's leading imperialist power that time was England, it's not Spain. Spain that time was losing other countries. Countries from Latin America and countries from Central America. But they're able to continue to conquer countries like Cuba, Puerto Rico, and the Philippines. It's because of this, the ability of the Spain to conquer other countries, they were able to have this kind of attributes in our country. Ito yung mga nangyayari sa bansa natin nung pinanganak, or at least bago pinanganak si Rizal. Okay, so England became a super power in terms of colonizing other countries. England was able to colonize these countries from Hong Kong to Malaysia. And then during the time also, since Spain is losing its power, Germany was able to exploit that opportunity. So naglaban yung Germany tsaka Spain in terms of owning the land. Kasi mas nauna pong nag-explore yung Spain, but eventually it yung ability to maintain that power na wala sa Spain. So nangingialam ngayon yung Germany. Now to resolve the ownership of the lands, kanino ba to? Sa Spain ba to o sa Germany? Ang nag-resolve niyan, arbiter means judge, ang nag-resolve niyan is Pope Leo XIII. Now during the time of Rizal, the church is very powerful. The church is very influential. Mas mataas ang kapangyarihan ng simbahan in terms of deciding a specific political decision. Mas kinoconsult ng gobyerno ang simbahan if they're going to decide on something. Crucial decision maker, the church. I'm going to explain later kung bakit napaka makapangyarihan ng simbahan during the time of Rizal. So ito po yung overview of the prologue. So let's discuss this one in our subsequent slides. This is the image of the Civil War. This is the image of Napoleon, the conqueror. This is the image of black slavery. Ito po yung mga panahon. Ito, these are the instances that happened during the time of Rizal. Black slavery was very rampant. So meaning to say people can be bought. And France was very influential also in terms of conquering other countries. And then the reason why these people, the Japanese people, are having blonde hairs because they were able to discover Western culture. Na-reopen yung Japan sa mundo. That's why their anime, kung mapansin niyo po yung anime ng Japan, supposed to be their makers, singkit yung mga mata nila kasi nga Asian sila. Pero they tried to create round eyes. Tingnan niyo yung mga mata ng mga anime characters bilugan. Kadalasan, blonde din yung buhok. It's because of the influence of the Western culture dun sa mindset ng Japan. And then this is Pope Leo XIII. This is Pope Leo XIII. Pope Leo XIII, and then its influence on Germany and then Spain. Let's go to the next slide. So let's examine this map. Asan dito yung Spain? Spain is located here. Ito, nandito yung Spain. So this is Central America. Central America and then Latin America. So yung Spain, during the time of Rizal, Spain wasn't able to maintain its colonies, its other colonies. Kasi nagsimula ang Spain mag-explore sa pamamagitan ng explorers nila, renowned explorers like Columbus and then Magellan. So ito yung Central America and then Latin America. Ito yung lahat. But since nawawala na to, Spain was able to colonize other countries like Cuba, Puerto Rico, and then the Philippines. Ang nagtataka kayo, I'm going to explain later, why Spain was able to colonize the Philippines. Eh, ang layo-layo ng Pilipinas, andito yung Pilipinas. Ang Spain, nandito. The reason for that is yung katabi po ng Spain, kung titingnan natin, ang katabi niya ni it's Portugal. So the world was divided into two. Hinati yan. This is the west and then this is the east. So the Portugal is a Catholic country and Spain is a Catholic country. So there's a problem in terms of economics. The problem why explorers like Columbus and then Magellan tried to explore other countries is because of the problem with scarcity. So maliit lang yung espasyo for them to sustain their resources. Ang ginawa ng Spain tried to colonize territories owned by Portugal. So in order to resolve this one, para ma-resolve yan, hinati yung mundo sa west, siya sa east. The west is owned by Spain and then the east is owned by Portugal. So ang tanong, technically speaking, Philippines should be owned and colonized by Portugal. Pero bakit na-discover siya ng Spain? Ang ginawa ng Spain through the person of Magellan, this is west. Ang ginawa ni Magellan, nag-travel siya dito sa west. And then he traveled here, dito sa Pacific Ocean. So ang dulo nito, dito siya lalabas. Ang unang bansa na bubungad sa kanya is the Philippines. That's the reason why Spain was able to colonize our country. Spain lost Central America, Costa Rica, and from Costa Rica, Honduras, Guatemala, El Salvador to Uruguay. Kita nyo yan dito. And then Cuba here, except for Cuba is here. Puerto Rico is a small country. Ito. So, bukod tangi ang Pilipinas ang malayo. Ang Central America and then Latin America, lahat yan nandito. Except for the Philippines. So, this is Spain. Yung Spain. Spain is a very significant country in Rizal. Kasi when Rizal tried to be in exile and escape the Spanish government, Rizal went to Spain. And then later on, Rizal traveled some popular European countries. Si Rizal meron pong rebulto sa Germany. So nag-travel si Rizal from Spain to France, to Germany and then to Italy. And yung mga bansang pinuntahan ni Rizal. Ito yung country natin na this is our country. Then let's check the Yap Island. So Spain originally discovered Yap Island. Ito yung Yap Island. It's almost beside our country. And Palau. Ito yung mga bansang na-discovery ng Spain. But Germany, again, merong conflict existing between Germany and Spain. So, Germany is claiming its right on the said island. So, Pope Leo ng ilalamang simbahan in order to resolve that obviously Pope Leo is a Spaniard. So ang Papa Boranhinidio is also a Spaniard. So Pope Leo, the head of the church, favored Spain. But Germany can make a coaling stations on these islands, and then Germany can make trade to Spain pa rin. So nandun yung bias ng simbahan dun sa kapwa niya country. So why is the church very powerful during the time of Rizal? The church was very powerful primarily because they own schools. Sila yung sinasabi nating enlightened because they're the authority of education. Knowledge is power, so if you own knowledge, you're going to be powerful. So during the time of Rizal, now the reason why the church is very powerful, we can trace this back during the Dark Ages. During the Dark Ages, that means prior to the Renaissance period. So ito yung panahon na kung saan nauso yung Crusades. Ito yung panahon na kung saan ang simbahan ang nilalapitan pagdating sa consultation of problems. It's the church. You can also check this out if you're familiar with even Game of Thrones. Ang pinaka hihingi ng advice ng hari ay yung mga taong nasa simbahan. Or even the pieces of chest, hindi mo maiiwasan yung piece of bishops. Now, if we're going to check our country, yung mga kilalang eskwelahan sa bansa natin, Lasal, Ateneo, and then UST. This is the original building of Ateneo. This is UST. Ang Lasal, lahat yan pagmamayari ng simbahan. Simbahan Katoliko. St. Paul sa simbahan pa rin. We have San Sebastian, San Beda. Lahat yan almost na-monopolize ng simbahan. Why? Kasi nga for the church, if you own knowledge, you own also the power to manipulate people. So let's check the first element present in the prologue. It's the instability of the colonial administration. When I say instability of the colonial administration, the reason why it's called unstable na yung colonial administration ng Spain is because Spain is losing its power. Ang nagiging makapangyarihan na is the United Kingdom. So the reason why the colonial administration of Spain is unstable, there's a struggle between the forces of despotism and liberalism. So what's the difference between despotism and then liberalism? So despotism, isa lang yung namumuno. Power belongs to one absolute entity. And in this case, despotism belongs, or the power belongs to one entity. That's sa Espanya, sino ang nagmamayari ng isang kapangyarihan kundi ang hari. If power belongs only to one entity, freedom. Okay, freedom is not being properly taken care of. So, ang dahilan kung bakit unstable na yung colonial administration, people wanted to have an effective leader. And majority of the, yung transfer kasi ng power ng hari, kadalasan walang election na nangyayari. Pag walang election nangyayari, ibig sabihin kahit hindi efficient or credible yung leader mo, magiging leader mo yan. Same thing applies, kung nanonood po kayo ng Game of Thrones, same thing applies to that type of example. Majority of the wars, karamihan ng mga digmaan na nangyayari sa mundo, it's because of inefficient leadership made by a king. Ang problema nga po dun sa transfer of power, if the king becomes old, the next successor of power ang magtatanggap ng kapangyarihan is the son of the king. Wala tayong katiyakan kung yung tatanggap ng next power and responsibility is efficient, same as the previous leadership. That's why people are very aggressive in terms of having an election, piliin kung sino talaga yung efficient to lead the society. Corruption during the time of Rizal, since limited nga po yung hindi na mo-monitor properly yung power, yung distribution of power. That's why corruption was very rampant too. Dalawang uri ng corruption ang rampant during the time, it's bribery and nepotism, which is also rampant during our contemporary time. When I say bribery, alin dito sa mga images would suggest bribery? Ito yun. Bribery, ibig sabihin lagay. If the law would not favor, kung hindi papaboran ng batas yung sitwasyon mo, the solution for that is bigyan mo ng pampadulas or lagay yung people who are taking care of the law, like the law enforcers and nepotism. So Spain was losing its power. Ang next solution ng Spain is to seek jobs in our country. What's nepotism? Nepotism is padrino system. Parent, spouse, child, and then grandparent. So yung trabaho, promotion of job, you'll be promoted to a higher position in employment if you are biologically related to the one who's in power. If I own the company, for example, if I will retire, the next in power is someone related to me, biologically speaking. So ito yung present po sa monarchy, nepotism. Pag nag-retire yung hari, ang next na magsasucceed dun sa power is the child or the son of the king. That's nepotism. So kung mapapansin nyo, almost more than 300 years ago, as in 1521, 1516, 1517, 1819, almost 500 years ago na pala, we were under the influence of Spain. 1521, our country was discovered by Magellan. And then such corruption, bribery, and nepotism, nandun na. Same type of corruption is still present in our country. So meaning to say, hanggang sa tumanda kayo, hanggang sa magkaroon kayo ng apo, yung bribery, nepotism, hindi yan mawawala sa gobyerno. Next is corrupt officials.